Disky Times, now available in stores around the country for only R3.50.
Disky TV powered by World Sports Betting. Orlando Pirates 2, Kaizer Chiefs 1 in the DStv Premiership, the biggest match of the football calendar so far this year. It's as big as it gets. It never gets bigger than Orlando Pirates and Kaizer Chiefs, the Soweto Derby. Machaka, as usual, always with us whenever Kaizer Chiefs is playing. Chucks, tough one to take, but it's not as bad as we had predicted it to be. Some people have predicted 3-4. You know, but your boys showed a little bit of character and fight. If they scored their penalty, of course, it could have been a different scoreline, maybe a draw as well. When now Thabile ka scoreline, how do you feel about the game?
Yeah, first of all, Nkuluks, re kudumedisa ba tlhomphe go lapeng le machita ka ofela le nka molo wena Nkuluks.
Lentswe le shule.
Yeah, you can hear.
Yeah,
let me clear my throat. Yeah, I'm clearing my throat, you know.
Sure.
Yeah. So, Nkuluks, all in all, let me just firstly say congratulations to Orlando Pirates.
Sure.
3 points at the back. Yeah, we can't reverse the game. If I was able to reverse the game, I was going to do it. But who am I? So, another thing, Nkuluks, I didn't expect the third wave from Orlando Pirates. Remember the first wave, they beat me 3-0. Second wave, it was 2-0. Now it's the third wave. Meaning, meaning we didn't have a good or the real vaccine. It was a fake one. and I thought we're going to sanitize Orlando Pirates today. Make no mistakes. I was confident. I was positive. Or today is today. The table should turn. It can't be a one way. No, there should be stop sign. There should be some robot. So you have to stop. Red robot. You cross all those kind of things. We can't expect to be beaten by Orlando Pirates.
One scoreline.
One way. No, it can't. It can't be like that. So another thing, Gulux, you tell me. If Nogovic can score, we blame RJ that war. Coach, if Ngezana can score, we blame RJ that war. Coach, and if Umanyama can score, so we blame RJ that war.
Yeah, so, I think you, I'm so sorry to cut you. I think you make a very good point that, look, if you look at Manyama's opportunity, number one, Ofori makes a huge blunder. This plays into the hands of Kamanyama. Whatever happens there, as a professional, try and make something better out of that. Secondly, the penalty. Nurkovic, do better. Or the follow-through of the penalty. Ngezana, geez, man. You score that one. You score that one. Like, I get his point that you don't blame a coach for that. Of course, you could talk about the tactics and the way that coach approached the game. Maybe he was the one even who implemented the offside trap and asked the guys to push and compress the midfield. Maybe you can blame him for that. But the open opportunities, you can't blame the coach for that.
Absolutely, as well. You can't blame the coach for that, Nkuluks. So, and also, you can't play offside trap against Orlando Pirates. You deserve to be beaten. You deserve a hiding. And you can't do that. I mean, they did it from the first whistle. You could see, they put the ball through, so it was an offside many times. But I could see that, you know what, the goal is coming from the parent. Danger is coming. Yeah. You can't. You know what? You can't have a sweet with a plastic on it. How are you going to eat that sweet? So it was coming. It was coming. Especially, I don't know if it was a coach system or what. Mm-hmm. But all in all, Nkuluks, also all in all, Paris, they packed the midfield as well. You could even see. I mean, I don't get the Chiefs players. You can't leave Monaro. Monaro was he was cruising. Mm. I'm telling you, he was cruising. He was on his own. He could even trap the ball, have that ball, and try to pass to his teammates. You know, without pressure. You put pressure on Orlando Pirates, especially in the middle of park. So if you can't do that, then what do you do? You deserve to be punished as well. Mm. So all in all, I don't know, that I'm saying tactics of the coach as well. But the Pirates, I think, you know what, they took their chances. We as Kaizer, you know, from back from the from Cape Town City and also from Stellenbosch and also from
AmaZulu.
You know what? We're scoring first all the time. That's what I'm saying. I didn't understand why Manyama couldn't. It was now we'd be talking a different story. You know, all in all, we can't blame a coach. I think we don't deserve to lose like this. Mm. You know, as I'm a coach, you know, we've been doing well coming to this game, Orlando Pirates. I think the preparations were going very, very well. As I'm saying, the last ball, you can put the ball in the back of the net. So we have to blame ourselves, my brother. You know, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Orlando Pirates, they deserve to win, because they took their chances. We didn't take our chance. So all in all, congratulations to them, but I can't talk about the drawing board all the time. No, I'm tired of that, my brother. So
yeah, would you sometimes we always look at it this way, and maybe with us analysts and people who are a little bit more neutral, with you I can understand why you would want Chiefs to win.
Yeah.
Do you look at your players and think that they are better than Orlando Pirates players? Like, do you come to this game today and feel like you could win?
No, pound to pound, you can't measure Orlando Pirates players. You could see. I mean, even they made some substitute. Mago came as well. You could see. You can even see Mdambo and even so what do you expect? You know, pound for pound. But as I've said to you, if you get a chance of Orlando Pirates, put the ball in the back of the net. That's it. And manage the game in the second half. So, but if you can't score, you know, I mean, with the clear chances like that, so what do you expect? That's what I'm saying. Orlando Pirates, I don't know why they are not even at number one or number two. They've got quality. They're good players. You know, movement of the ball, great passes. I mean, you could even see, they are playing a very good football. How they are not there, I don't know. But as well, to the Glamour boys that I'm saying are going forward in Gulux, we just have to rectify mistakes and going forward and make sure that we win our next game. But as I've said to you, beaten up by Orlando Pirates, it's tough, my brother. It's tough to swallow. It's a bitter pill to swallow. But you've got to take it, my brother. We are not effective enough to put the ball in the back of the net. Even Ofori could even see made one mistake. We should have punished him as well. So if you can punish Orlando Pirates by their own mistakes.
Yeah.
So what do you expect? Mm. So looks all in all, it's football, my brother. If you don't take any chances in football, you can play whatever you play, you can do whatever you do. But even the referee, my brother, I think the referee was man of the match today. I don't know. I think maybe he needs some glasses. I think if they allow the referee to wear some glasses, that guy should wear some glasses. I mean, even Orlando Pirates, they have a clear penalty, my brother. Clear penalty. Pirates should have given Orlando Pirates a penalty.
Yeah, fair play.
He did give us a penalty, which is understandable.
It was a penalty.
Yeah. But on the side of Orlando Pirates, it was also a penalty. How he didn't give, that's why he even gave some other players from Orlando Pirates what? Some yellow cards. I don't know. Officiating, I think, is a problem in South Africa. Sure. They should just rectify that as well.
All right. Every match is 90 minutes, which is almost 2 hours. And in 2 hours, there are always positives, whether it's small positives or bigger ones that come with victories. Even if you lose 5-0, there's always something bright. I think we can agree, Ukuthi, Ungcobo was not that positive today because of where he was playing. Ngubani odlaleka kahle ku team yakho namhlanje that you will say, at least I will sleep better because this guy fought for us today.
No, I don't want to single anybody. As you are saying, no, but he didn't play well today. Absolutely. I think they did manage him, Orlando Pirates. They came with their own plan to say, you know what, let's put Ngobo in the box. He mustn't have a ball to play. So, and he didn't play for Orlando Pirates. I mean, but Kado said at least he scored, you know. It's a positive. He scored, it's a positive, you know. But how did he score? That's the thing. So, I think all in all, my brother, I don't want to single some players.
Sure.
They did play all of them. That's why they created some few chances. They couldn't put the ball in the back of the net. We continue doing that. But with Blomo, I think Blomo was not there as well. Pagas, at least, you could see that, especially in the middle of the park.
Yes.
Pagas, he did very Sometimes did very well, absolutely did very well. Mashiani came as well. I thought Mashiani will start the game with Ngobo at the same time. But a coach, you know, he saw something. That's why he didn't put Mashiani, especially in the first half.
Mm-hmm.
And also Uzuma, he came. I don't think he did give us much more. What I could see is Frostler. Frostler was now effective, especially in the second half going forward, you know, getting those crosses.
Yeah.
Zulu today, not effective as well on the left side.
Yeah.
I didn't see him very well. So all in all, when we look at him, Frostler was, I think we could even get a goal through Frostler. But all in all, guys, that I'm saying, we can't be harsh on them. You know what, that's what I'm saying. But we should blame them that if you're getting a chance against a team like Orlando Pirates, finish it. Punish Orlando Pirates.
Yeah.
So now, I don't know, Ngulux. But all in all, that I'm saying, going back to the drawing board, if you're still there at Nature Arena. Hunt, you know, you lose again. Third game against Orlando Pirates.
In a row.
I told you about the third wave. So it's the problem on our side. You understand? There is no Khlemlach. No smile, nothing. We'll just go back home and do whatever we want to do, guys. We continue, we forge ahead. It's 3 points, you know, being beaten by Orlando Pirates or even by AmaZulu or whatever, any team, it's 3 points. So let's regroup, guys. let's continue to fight. We must fight a good fight going forward. So we can't let it slip now because we have beaten Palermo Paris. Now, guys, let's just, you know, just go back and have a warm bath and make sure that you continue doing well. For the Glamour Boys.
All right. Up next for Kaizer Chiefs, of course, is the Nedbank Cup. So hopefully, I think they were drawn against a lower side team from KZN. It could be Utongati or Richards Bay. I stand to be corrected. So that's next weekend. Sundowns as well in midweek and Orlando Pirates as well. So up next is the Nedbank Cup. Hopefully, they can pick up the form. At least, Amakhosi azojabula. There you go, then. That was a game. Diski Times on CO.ZA, Diski TV is on Facebook. We have over 55,000 followers there, over 65,000 followers here. On subscribers here on Facebook, on YouTube. We thank you very much for watching our videos.